I'm here with our exercise guru, Ben Eater.
Hi, Sal.
And we are looking at this module you've made called Exploring Mean and Median. And let's see what it says. Arrange the five orange points. So these are the orange points right over here. On the number line, so the arithmetic mean is negative 0.1. And arithmetic mean is really kind of what we traditionally view as the average.
It's the average, yeah.
You add up the numbers and divide by the number that you have.
Right.
And that the median is 2.5. And 2.5 is essentially the middle number if you have an odd number of numbers, which
right,
we do
which
here.
We do.
Or if you have an even number of numbers, it's the arithmetic mean of the middle two numbers.
Yeah.
It's really going kind of right
halfway
in
between
halfway
them.
Between the middle two numbers. And they're both ways of measuring kind of central tendency.
Right.
And the distance between adjacent tick marks is 1. So this is like, so this one right over here is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is -1, this is -2. And so the whole point, what's the point of this exercise?
The point of it, well, you said they're both ways of measuring central tendency.
Right.
But what we can see here is that they don't always give you the same answer. So we're being asked to see an arithmetic mean of negative 0.1 and a median of 2.5. Those are very different numbers.
Yeah.
So how can you take 5 points and say the central tendency is -0.1
right,
and the central tendency is 2.5?
Right. And there's just different ways of measuring
it. There's different ways of measuring it, and sometimes one way is better than
exactly,
the other.
Exactly, exactly.
And you kind of have to know.
And you immediately see, I was just starting to play with it, and you see, if I take this, the highest number here, and I change it, I can change the mean, but it didn't change the median, because the middle number is still this middle number, no matter what's going on out here. And that's why, actually, the median tends to be viewed as a better measure when you have outliers, when you have really, 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 you know, large values or really, really, really small values, the median is a little bit more robust. So if like this thing is just some crazy large number, the median didn't change much.
Right.
Even though this one number being large took the whole arithmetic mean up. The same thing out here, if I had an outlier over here, it doesn't change the median.
So in this case, it's asking us a mean of -0.1 and a median of 2.5. Those are very far apart.
Right.
So you might expect a lot of outliers.
Right.
So when we're done, you probably would think a lot of the points are going to be closer to 2.5.
Let's think about this. So let me get the median first. So the median is just a middle number.
Right.
And so, and here there's five numbers. So the middle number literally has to be 2.5.
So one of those outs has to be on 2.5.
So let me make the middle number 2.5. So that gets me to 2.5. That's got to be the
middle. You're looking at the mean there.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. Sorry, I'm looking at the mean. 2.5 is the median. Median is 2.5. And now I want to get the mean at negative 0.1. So let me start making this, see what I can do to make negative. The mean still is not, so let's see. Mean, look, there you go.
There we go.
So let me check my answer. Yeah, so this you see that there are.
So, yeah, which of those numbers do you think better represents the central tendency?
Yeah, well.
I don't know.
You don't know in this case, right?
Yeah.
Either one is. So let's see. If they were all grouped and there was a couple of outliers, then the median probably would have been better.
Yeah. And there might be different ways to arrange those dots, too, and you can play with them.
Yeah. No, that'd be interesting. So let me check. I got it right. Let's do another one. Next question. All right. Arrange the 10 dots. Okay, same thing. We want the mean 3.6, median at 6. So let me think about the median first. So I want to get the middle number 2, median at 6. Huh? So the median is 6.
You need to drag one more dot over because you're going to be between the two middle numbers because you have an even
number of points. Oh, yes, you're right. So we're the median is taking the right. So here we go. Median is now 6.
Yep.
Very good. Right. I had to worry about middle two numbers because I had an even number.
That's right.
And now let me see the mean. I need to get to 3.6. The mean I need to get to, and I can't make this one of the middle numbers, then it'll distort my median. I guess it can be one of, it can't get.
Yeah, you can't go past that
number. Yeah. So let's see, I want to go to 3.6. 3.6 gets me right over there.
There you go.
And
so here, which of those numbers do you think is a better central tendency?
I would say the median in this one,
in
because
that case,
these feel
so.
A little bit more outlier-like,
right?
At least in this situation, the way we've set up this distribution. Let's check the answer. Well, that's satisfying. Get the smiley face. And you also have hints here if someone has trouble with
that's
it.
That's right. And they can actually show you maybe a different way to do it.
Yep. So you define the median as a middle number. Then you show dragging points. So let's see. So an example. Let's see. So this is an example. Okay, this is an example where the median and the mean are both 6.
Right. So that just puts half the points to the left of the median, half the points to the right.
Right. That makes sense. And then you could keep going, but that doesn't solve the problem.
No, that's.
So let's see. And then you explain. So you just give a little more explanation there. And then finally, you talk about how you change this so that you can get the mean at 3.6. So let's see if you show that example. So there you go.
So it just moves a couple outliers out.
Outliers, so just the mean, but then the median doesn't change. Right. Very interesting.